Good morning. With today's session, we are going to learn about metals, alloys, and ceramics. So at the end of this session, students will be able to explain the metal and their alloys and ceramic materials. Content of today's session, we are going to learn about metal, alloys, and ceramics. Introduction. A metal is a material which shows a lustrous appearance, conducts electricity and heat relatively well, and are typically malleable as well as ductile. Types of ions. First ion is a cast ion composition. Iron, 92% to 94% of the iron is present. Carbon, 2.5% to 4% of the carbon is present. Silicon, 0.7% to 3%. Phosphorus, 0.5%. Manganese, 0.2% to 1%, and sulfur is 0.1%. This is the composition of cast iron. Properties of cast iron. It is neither malleable nor ductile. It cannot be forged, rolled, or welded. It cannot be magnetized permanently. It is very soft and brittle. It has low tensile strength. It melts at 1150 degrees Celsius to 1250 degrees Celsius. It expands on solidification. It does not rust easily. Applications of cast iron. It is used for casting metal objects such as stores, drainage covers, pipes, railings, etc. It is also used in making toys, radiators, cooking utensils, water and drain pipes. Is used in making agricultural equipments, used in making electric poles, burners, etc. Also used in making wrought iron and steel. Second ion, it is steel. Composition, iron 95% to 96%, carbon 0.05%, manganese 1%, phosphorus 0.05%, sulfur 0.5%, silicon 0.03%. This is the composition of steel. Properties of steel. It is soft and hard. It is malleable as well as ductile. It has highest tensile strength. It melts between 1200 to 1500 degrees Celsius. It can be magnetized permanently. It can be welded. Applications. It is used in making machinery parts, girders, bridges, etc. In making magnets, razors, springs, etc. In constructional works, also it is used. Third type of iron, that is a wrought iron. Composition, almost 99% of the iron is present. Percentage of carbon present is 0.12 to 0.25%, and rest all, that is 0.3%, almost impurities are present. Properties, it is soft and fibrous in nature. It is gray and tough, medium tensile strength. It is malleable as well as ductile. Melting point is 1530 degrees Celsius. It can be welded. It cannot be permanently magnetized. Applications of wrought iron. It is used in making chains, hooks, tools. Also used in manufacture of bars and wires. Used in making bolts, nails, railway couplings, etc. And can be used in making electromagnets and agricultural equipments. Pause this video and answer this question. The melting point of the wrought iron is A, 1400 degrees Celsius, B, 1450 degrees Celsius, C, 1530 degrees Celsius, and D is 1600 degrees Celsius. Well, the answer for for this question, that is the melting point of the wrought iron is C, that is 1530 degrees Celsius. Alloys. An alloy is a metallic, intimately mixed, solid mixture of two or more or a different metals, elements, one of which at least is essentially bimetal. Purpose of making an alloy? To enhance the hardness of metal, to lower the melting point, to enhance tensile strength, to enhance corrosion resistance, to modify color, to provide better castability, to reduce malleability as well as the ductility, and to change chemical reactivity. Classification of alloys. Basically, there are two types of alloys. One is called as ferrous alloys. The second one is a non-ferrous alloys. The first one is ferrous alloys. The alloy having iron as one of the main component, that is base metal, are known as a ferrous alloys. For instance, steel, plain and carbon steel, steel alloys, etc. Second type is non-ferrous alloys. The alloys which do not have iron as one of the main component are known as non-ferrous alloys. In these, the main component is other than iron. For instance, aluminium alloys like or copper alloys, nickel alloys, etc. We can watch this video just to understand regarding the alloys.
Alloy is a homogeneous mixture of two or more metals, or of a metal and a non-metal mixed in fixed proportion by mass in their molten states. Alloying is a very good method of improving the properties of a metal. We can achieve the desired properties by using this method. For example, iron is the most widely used metal, but it is never used in its pure state because it is very soft and easily stretchable when hot. But if iron is mixed with a small amount of carbon, then it becomes hard and strong. When iron is mixed with nickel and chromium, we get stainless steel, which is hard and does not rust. Similarly, pure gold, that is 24 karat gold, is very soft and hence is not suitable for making jewelry. So, it is alloyed with silver and copper to make it hard. Alloy of the metal mercury is called as amalgam. Copper is a good conductor of electricity, but when mixed with zinc to form brass or mixed with tin to form bronze, it loses its conducting property. An alloy of lead and tin, which is called as solder, has a low melting point and is thereby used for welding electrical wires together.
Next one, ceramics. These are inorganic non-metallic materials that are processed and used at high temperature. They include silicates, metallic oxides and their combinations. The basic materials used to make ceramics are called as clay. Generally, ceramics are prepared by heating clay materials at high temperature. Classification. Classification is based on application as well as we can classify them on the basis of the structure. Classification based on applications. First, abrasives, example, alumina, carborundum. Second, minerals, that is quartz. Cementing materials, example, cement and lime. Fourth, refractories, example, silica. clay materials like bricks, tiles, etc. Sixth one, rocks, example granite, sandstones, etc. Classification based on structure. Crystalline ceramics, example carborundum. Amorphous ceramics, examples oxides. Crystalline and amorphous ceramics, that is cement, and fourth one is glassy ceramics. Properties of ceramics, chemical as well as physical properties. It is having high chemical stability. It shows resistance to highly oxidizing and reducing atmosphere, resistance to heat and temperature, corrosive atmosphere, as well as to oils and organic solvents. Mechanical properties. It shows resistance to compression, does not undergo wear and tear, poor shock resistance. Electrical and magnetic properties. It is a bad conductor of heat as well as electricity. The non-oxide ceramics acts as a semiconductors. Ceramics containing transition metal ions shows magnetic properties. Magnetic ceramics responds to magnetic field known as magnetic susceptibility. References for this, I have used textbook of engineering chemistry by Jain and Jain and YouTube link for the content. Thank you.